With just 3 months to go in 2014, we have a pretty good idea of what the year-end fight of the year ballot is going to look like. As usual, this year produced a solid handful of fights that will stand the test of time. Let's take a look now at the five best fights so far in 2014. Showtime might have taken some flack for their events this year, but one of those turned out to be a bona fide Fight of the Year contender. Robert Guerrero and Yoshihiro Kamigai put on a tremendous display of infighting at the StubHub Center, much to the surprise of the boxing media and fans alike. It was presumed that Guerrero would be too skilled and too powerful for Kamigai, but from the early going, it was Kamigai on the offensive.
There's the uppercut that we talked about, but Guerrero using his as well.
Nonetheless, the Ghost wound up being a bit too accurate for Kamigai all night long and cemented himself as one of the sport's most exciting premium cable fighters. The most recent addition to everyone's Fight of the Year ballot is Orlando Salido's 11th round knockout over Turdsak Kokajim. Salido Turdsak looked a lot different than your typical Fight of the Year contender, which are usually characterized by extreme volume punching. In this case, it wasn't the amount of punches that made it special, but the intention behind every single punch both men threw. Salido and Turdsak were seemingly going for the knockout with every shot, and came very close many times. Overall, the fight featured 7 knockdowns, 3 apiece, before the final blow from Salido. Perhaps the first entrant onto the ballot this year was a phone booth slugfest between two physical middleweights, Turiano Johnson and Curtis Stevens. Johnson applied relentless pressure and forced Stevens to bang away with him on the inside. Stevens landed his trademark home run left hook all night long, and Johnson continued to stand his ground and pound away. Over the course of the night, Stevens landed 45% of his power punches, while Johnson landed 39%. This one would be remembered even more fondly, if not for the rather unsavory ending.
Just around a minute to go, and the ref stopped the fight.
John Molina almost scored an upset of the year contender against Lucas Matisse, but will certainly get the nod as one half of Fight of the Year on many ballots. Molina and Matisse traded power shots and traded knockdowns in what has been the best premium cable fight so far in 2014. Though he has a reputation for dramatic comeback knockouts, in searching for one late in this fight, Molina was eventually caught and stopped by Matisse. The bloody battle only served to boost the stock of both fighters in the hands of both fans and the networks. And lastly, the strawweight war between Francisco Rodriguez Jr. and Katsunari Takayama is not only likely the clubhouse leader for Fight of the Year in 2014, it might be the best fight in the history of the 105-pound weight class. The amount of punches thrown and the lack of clinches were both equally as astonishing. Rodriguez Takayama also has a leg up on the competition because of the stakes of the fight itself. This wasn't a couple of gutsy club fighters providing this action. This was a strawweight unification bout between two of the division's very best, which also resulted in a fantastic fight. Rodriguez got the nod on the scorecards, one of which was unfathomably wide, but a rematch is welcome anytime. There are a few contenders on paper left on the boxing schedule this year, including Timothy Bradley, Diego Chavez, and Curtis Stevens, Hassan and Dom, but most likely, these will be the five fights we remember most when we look back on 2014.